G'day, Bruce.
G'day, Bruce.
How are you, Bruce?
I'm a bit crook, Bruce. I just saw a poppy streaker in the Earls Court Road.
Must have looked like a bald wallaby.
Good evening, ladies and Bruces. Bruce and myself come from the philosophical department of the University of Woolloomooloo. I'm in charge of logical positivism, and Bruce is in charge of the sheep dip. And we've been asked to come along here and tell you a little about some of the wonderful philosophers we study in Australia. We've agreed to tell you a little about these philosophers under one condition. Condition one,
no posters!
What's the condition?
No posters!
There's a couple of digger deviants up there in the balcony, I think, but apart from that, we're fairly safe.
Well spotted, Bruce.
Emmanuel Kant was a real peasant, he was very rarely stable. I Degger was a boozy beggar who could think you under the table. David Hume could out-consume Schopenhauer and Hegel. And Wittgenstein was a beery swine who was just as sloshed as Schlegel. There's nothing Nietzsche couldn't teach about the raising of the wrist. Socrates himself was permanently pissed. John Stuart Mill of his own free will, on off by the shandy, was particularly ill. Plato, they say, could stick it away, half a grain of whiskey every day. Aristotle was a bugger for the bottle. Hobbes was fond of his dram, and René Descartes was a drunken fart. I drink, therefore I am. Yes, Socrates himself is particularly missed. Ah, lovely little thinker about a bugger when he's pissed.